Thank you so much, JD, for introducing me so beautifully for the lovely audience. What a lovely theme we have got for the meeting. The key to success is knowing yourself, and I just want to add one line of it, said by the great philosopher Socrates. He said, knowing yourself is the beginning of wisdom, like JD also pointed out the same. Fellow Toastmasters and guests, good evening.
Good evening.
Between the eye and knowing exists a glass, a magical glass, which transforms a young girl or a boy into an object of lust. Whoa. A beggar into a feeling of pity. A gold into something precious. A star into a distant object. A death into dread. And the color red into red. What is the key to know oneself? When I search the option, okay, let me see how can one person successfully describe the use of knowing oneself. I found the answer in the Upanishad, the ancient Indian inscription, which says that you are what your driving desire is. You are what your driving desire is. As a driving desire, you can actually, if you have the desire in your life, you can go miles. And like the Upanishad says, as you desire, so is your will. As your will, so is your deed. As your deed, so is your destiny. And to reach the destiny successfully, we need to have a strong desire. And that strong desire can be found only when you know yourself. And we know about one person who knew both his desire and the desire of every individual and founded Toastmasters International, Dr. Ralph Smedley. The first meeting was held on 22nd of October 1924 in Santa Ana, California. The club was Smedley's Chapter 1 Club. And this organization is serving over 313,000 members right now in 126 countries with 14,850 clubs. We all are proud to be associated with Toastmasters, aren't we?
Yes.
And to bring the meeting forward for the benefit of the guests, the meeting of Toastmasters has three parts. The first part is table topics, in which any of the person here can be called up on the stage and asked to speak about 2 minutes on any random topic. The second session is prepared speech, where the speakers come prepared and they deliver a speech for a typical time of 5 to 7 minutes. And the third and the final session is evaluation of the prepared speakers, where we're going to have a Toastmaster to be evaluating all the speeches. And the one person who monitors the entire evaluation process is the general evaluator. And today, as a general evaluator, we have a person who is a fabulous speaker. He's a consultant and a Toastmaster for a decade. He is the champion of evaluation. I see, even if I go to a different club or any conference of Toastmasters, people speak about him for his evaluation. He is a fantastic tennis player as well. Please put your hands up for the general evaluator, Jos Paul.
Thank you, Karnakar, for the flattering introduction. Fellow Toastmasters and dear guests, a very good evening to each one of you. And as the title itself suggests, as a general evaluator, I would be evaluating all the aspects of the meeting today, right from the time it has started and till the close of the meeting when we would be giving a report during the general evaluation session. And I have a team to assist me in this, and we call this team as the tag team. T represents the timer. And today, we have Toastmaster Vijay, who would be keeping the time for us, and he would please spell out the role, Mr. Vijay.
Time is very important. So time to relax is only when you don't have time for it. So to keep the track of today's time, I've got a few rules. So at the end of for the table topics, 1 to 2 minutes, at the end of 1 minute, I will be showing you white card. At the end of 1.5 minutes, I'll be showing you orange card, and at the end of 2 minutes, I'll be showing you red card. So for this, same thing holds good for prepared speech, where in which at the end of 5 minutes, I'll be showing you white card. At the end of 6th minute, I'll be showing you orange. And at the end of 7th minute, I'll be showing you red card. At the end of the 7th minute, you'll have to do a hard stop. Back to you.
Thank you, Toastmaster Vijay. And A in the tag denotes the R counter. And we have Toastmaster Jose would be the R counter for today. Mr. Jose, could you please spell out your role today?
Yeah, so I'll be closely monitoring the speeches, the table topics. And I'll be counting the short pauses, the long pauses, the filler words, and the pass. And I'll be giving the report at the end of the evaluation.
Thank you. And G represents the grammarian. We have Toastmaster Inder, who would be the grammarian of today's meeting. Mr. Inder, could you please spell out your role?
Yes. Good evening, everyone. As a grammarian, I would be noting down the good usage and not so good usage of the words. And I would be presenting my report to the general evaluator at the end of the session. Today, the word of the day is abjure. Example, although chocolate is my favorite dessert, I chose to abjure it while in my diet. I would request the speaker to use the word of the day in their speeches. Thank you.
Thank you, Inder. And that would briefly sum up the role of the general evaluator and the team during this meeting. Thank you. Over to you, Toastmaster.